everyone, my name is Martina and I'm super excited to welcome you to this tutorial. Today I'll walk you through Arturo's powerful virtual instrument, the OBXAV. To begin, let's listen to some of its epic presets. Released in December 1980, the OBXA made a huge statement in the world of analog synths with its impressive power, polyphony, and ambitious build. Four decades later, our exciting recreation comes to life. We've enriched it with the unique flavors from the OB series that will make it the perfect bread and butter synth machine for keyboardists, synth programmers, and innovative musicians. OBXAV comes with a classic subtractive signal path and is equipped with 16 voices. First off, we will cover its front panel and then we'll dive into the advanced features. Right at the heart of our virtual instrument, you'll find two powerful oscillators. Both of them provide three different waveforms: triangle, saw, and square. They also have independent tuning knobs, a pulse width shaper, a detune parameter, as well as cross-modulation and hard sync features. Let's explore them now by manipulating their settings. You can play around with the oscillator 1 frequency and waveform selector parameters to find something that will suit your sound. To try the second oscillator, make sure to increase its volume in the mixer section. You can balance between oscillator 1, oscillator 2, and noise sources to deliver satisfying results. Oscillator number 2 comes with the same set of waveforms, but its pitch range is modified by semitones, not octaves. You can also detune any selected frequencies for oscillator number 2. The X-mod knob, which stands for cross-modulation, can provide some drastic changes, allowing oscillator 2 to modulate oscillator 1 with its currently selected waveform. The filter module contains frequency, resonance, and modulation knobs, as well as the switch between 4-pole and 2-pole modes, plus the key tracking button. Let's set the pulse wave in both of the oscillators and then slowly sweep across the whole range of the cutoff parameter. Now that the sound is dull and closed, let's crank up the resonance to the maximum and slowly open up the cutoff knob to hear the whole range of sweeping frequencies. You can also change the position of the modulation knob. That will set the amount of effect that the envelope has on the filter. Make sure to try all these controls with both the 4-pole and the 2-pole modes switched on. The first one is 24 dB and the other one is 12 dB per octave. The 2-pole setting doesn't lose too much bass and volume with high resonance values, which might be useful when making bass sounds. In contrast to that, we've modeled the 4-pole based on the original, meaning that the high resonance values will lead to a decrease in volume, so you can use it on more lush and subtle tones. OBXAV is equipped with two classic polyphonic envelopes. One is dedicated to the filter, and the second one controls the VCA. Their various settings will affect how the sound behaves over time. These lower attack values for each envelope will result in the filter or VCA reaching its highest values in a longer time. Decay and sustain will set the point at which the sound will sustain after reaching the maximum attack position, while various release values will determine how long the sound will be held after you release the key or a pad. As we mentioned before, the mod knob in the filter section will determine how much of an impact the filter envelope will have on the cutoff parameter. In the OBXAV, the module has its own dedicated section. That becomes very practical because you can choose from a selection of handy controls over its character, such as the waveform selector. However, most importantly, you can route it either to oscillator 1, oscillator 2, or both oscillators at once. What you might find special for the OBXAV's Portamento is the fact that it's polyphonic, which means that each voice is affected independently. You can use it in a traditional way of gliding the notes with the dynamic bass or lead sounds. You can also experiment and turn on the quantize option. This one will produce a unique effect, especially with the longer time settings. OBXAV is equipped with a super cool arpeggiator mode that was not included in the hardware classic. You can get a lot out of it thanks to its well-equipped features. The rate is determined either by hertz or time divisions. Inside the pattern tab, you will find two variables, the ARP's playback directions and the range of octaves that it can work with. To get some interest, we can play two different chords and set its rate to hertz mode and use the random playback direction with 3 octaves of range. The modulation section has a built-in LFO and allows for a tactile and hands-on approach. One of the cool tricks to use here are the self-playing melodies where LFO replaces your hands and produces various note changes. To achieve that, simply activate the hold button, then set the LFO rate to around 1/12th time division, its waveform to sample, and hold smoothed. Then set the depth knob to the maximum and enable oscillator 1 frequency, oscillator 2 frequency, and filter frequency as the destinations. Now the LFO will cause the oscillators to change their pitch constantly at a fast rate, with the smooth random waveform modulating both of them. This section contains the master volume and master tuning, but it also shines with some creative features. It's here where you can turn on the hold button to keep your arpeggios running or enter the chord mode. The latter will allow you to play chords with just one finger. To do that, simply activate it, open up the select button, and pick the notes that will build your chord, which can contain up to 12 notes. The voicing section allows you to activate the famous OBXA unison mode that will make all the chords and pads sound very big. You can also use its few handy and great sounding stereo image functions that will make your sound really stand out. Stay with me to find out all about it in the second episode.